Hello everyone and welcome to yet another episode of the Virtual Ninja Show. My name is Heike and I will be your host. Today we talk about SSPM and what that means. We will go there in a moment. But before, do you remember these? Are you looking forward to getting one of those? Check out how on aka.ms/plushcat. So today I have David with me. He is my expert when it comes to SSPM and who is and what it means. Please, David, introduce yourself.
Thank you, Heike. So my name is David Mallet. I am a program product manager at Microsoft, and I'm part of the customer experience and engineering team for one of our awesome products called Microsoft Defender for Cloud Apps. And SSPM, or SaaS, Security Posture Management, is the newest feature that we are adding to this product.
Tell me, David, what is SSPM?
So a bit of history first. For those who have used Microsoft Defender for Cloud Apps in the past, or formerly known as Cloud App Security or MCAS, you know that this is what we call a CASB, or Cloud Access Security Broker. The goal of a CASB is to help customers, number one, understand what is their cloud exposure, what kind of cloud applications are used, discover what we call shadow IT, meaning non-authorized apps. And for the apps that are authorized, you want to find out what kind of data is stored in them and what kind of threats they're subject to. Very quickly, that's a summary of what a traditional CASB is about. And this is something we've been delivering for the past few years, and we keep delivering because all of these pillars here are still critical. Now, they're critical, but they're not enough anymore. Now we're talking about SaaS security. That's a much bigger story. And you can see that the pillars we had at first, discovery, threat detection, and information protection are still here. But we're also adding SaaS to SaaS protection. For example, trying to identify which apps are connecting to your favorite office tenant and trying to leech off data off of it, for example. That's one aspect of what we're doing. And another aspect of what we're doing is SaaS security posture management. And the idea here is to make sure that we can understand and then remediate any misconfiguration or any non-best practice configuration within a customer apps and how they're configured.
So can I say that SaaS security is an evolution of CASB, and that basically everyone who offers now a SaaS security also includes a CASB, or is it a totally different thing? Or like, how can I see this?
Our approach is to integrate our SaaS security offers within the CASB. In terms of licensing, if that's the question for a lot of customers, everything I'm going to talk about today is already included, and there's nothing else to pay. If you already have Defender for Cloud Apps through E5, through standalone licensing, mm-hmm. You're going to be able to use everything we're talking about today free of charge. You already pay for it. I know that other solutions would compartmentalize and have different products for each of those pillars that you see in the screen right now. And that's not our approach. Our approach is to have something global, something integrated, where you have one product that can help you do all these things.
So those four, I would say five categories on the screen right now, like discover and information protection, continuous threat protection, SaaS to SaaS protection, SSPM, are basically categories.
Exactly. These are the pillars of features of the product. I often say that this product could be five different products. And again, you may have to pay for five products in other companies, but they're only one of them here. And we're integrating all these features together to give customers a simpler deployment and a more integrated deployment.
Just as a reminder for everyone, we did actually two Microsoft Defender for Cloud Apps episodes in season 2. So go check out aka.ms/ninja show, and then you see episodes on demand, and then scroll down a little bit if you want to dive deeper a little bit into what Microsoft Defender for Cloud Apps can do for you. What is all part of SSPM? Like, what does it need to do? What are requirements for something that wants to be called SSPM?
the idea of SaaS security posture management, or in general, security posture management, we know that right now, a majority of security failures that we see in the cloud are already human-driven. So that's really what we're trying to tackle here. And the idea of an SSPM solution is to take best practices for specific apps. And we're not talking about only Microsoft apps here. We're talking about different apps from different vendors and trying to understand those best practices, analyze how the application is configured, and provide the security admin a view of what deviates from best practices.
Can you give me an example of what is a misconfiguration for a SaaS application? What's a typical misconfiguration?
Session timeout needs to be configured properly. Password strength, it's a critical one. I'm not even talking about MFA because everybody has MFA on now. Who doesn't? So these are example. It can be password policy. Depending on the app, there are different things we're able to check, different things we consider best practices. That's where we're going. But as you mentioned, password, MFA, anything that has some security requirements, that's what we're targeting. Security posture is critical because that's really the strength of the organization. If an organization has a poor configuration of their SaaS, which very often now contain the keys to the kingdom, that's a problem for the entire organizations. Hence the idea of SSPM or security posture management in general, not just for SaaS, but in general for identity, for cloud platform. But here, really, we're focusing on SaaS.
And then it means automated and continuous monitoring. Okay, I got it. Okay, so it means it's nothing that you just run once in a while. So that actually goes continuously and reports back if there is something.
Indeed, our tool is going to periodically, on a short intervals, try to review the configuration, see if it changed. And if the configuration changed, is not the same as prior, we will also make sure that this appears in the console and admins are able to remediate it.
How do we know what is a best practice for a third-party application or like a third-party cloud application?
Two ways that we follow for that. Number one, vendors' best practice. When we check for best practices on Salesforce, well, we find out what they say in Salesforce documentation that should be done. And we spent a great deal of time researching that, making sure that we were adhering to best practices. That's number one. Number two, and that we do even for Microsoft applications, is public benchmarks. So for example, for Office, we are now working on following all the recommendations of CIS benchmark to make sure that we will not only follow our best practices, but also industry best practices and industry recommendations.
Okay. Okay. So there is a lot of human research behind it to make sure that the configuration is applied properly. Okay, cool. Thank you.
So time for a demo. So this is the Microsoft Defender 365 portal, and this is our single pane of glass for all of security apps. Defender for Endpoint, Defender for Office, obviously Defender for Cloud Apps. And there are also global sections. And you can see the first global section that we see here is Secure Score. And that integrates best practices and security posture for different areas, identity, data, device, and apps. So here you have a quick summary on the front page, but we're going to dig into it by clicking in Secure Score. So again, on the Secure Score homepage, you have the top recommendations. They're not necessarily related to cloud apps, but they're here, and we can see which one have the biggest impact. So now digging into recommended actions, we can see a full list of recommendations, everything for every applications, for every Microsoft product that we have out there. And if you see in the list of products, we have, of course, the Microsoft security products, but we have your SaaS. And non-Microsoft ones are included, like Citrix, like Salesforce, ServiceNow, all these things, Okta, all these things are here. And we're going to filter out the rest so you can have a quick overview of what we have that is reported by Defender for Cloud Apps as part of this SSPM offer. And here you can see a good list. So we have examples. Let's click on one just to see what it looks like when we do. And here in the pane that opens, you can see the description, why it's the best practice, why it's so important. And you can also see the steps to implement it, as well as a quick link. You can just send your Salesforce admin so that they know exactly what to do and where is the problem. You can see that there's a status column. We mentioned earlier, we constantly are looking for the settings here. And if we see that something is being fixed, then we'll have the green mark showing up and we'll mark it as completed.
Do you remember those? It's time to remember you. So if you would like to get the chance to get one of those ninja cats, go to aka.ms/plushcat. And now back to David.
When you took care of one of those recommendations, they're going to show up with the little green mark and they're going to show up as completed. And that will increase the overall secure score of the organization.
Do I see, usually, oh, this is the score impact, right? So there's a column that shows me basically if you fix some of it, how it will impact the secure score. Okay.
Exactly. Awesome. Exactly. Mm-hmm. Based on that, you can identify which one are the most critical. And if your goal is to use the gamification aspect of it and try to increase your secure score as much as possible, you can pick up the highest numbers, of course.
And then what does it mean that it's like points achieved and some have like more than one? Like, is this like multiple settings?
It can be multiple instances of the same problem. It really depends on the recommendation. But when there are multiple instances of the same problem, they're going to show up as multiple points.
So deployment, is there anything people need to do or how do you get this up and running?
Well, that's the beauty of it. There's almost nothing you have to do. Of course, it depends how you configured your Defender for Cloud Apps in the first place. But this is all part of the basic setup of Microsoft Defender for Cloud Apps. So if you go to the settings and go under Cloud Apps, you have a page called App Connectors. So usually, if you already have Defender for Cloud Apps in your environment and you are already using those applications, you already have them connected in your environment, then there's nothing to do. If Salesforce is already configured, then Salesforce is already configured. You will just have the results showing up. Maybe they're already there in your environment. You can check the settings, verifying that the connection is properly configured and works and that everything is enabled. But other than that, if your app is connected, then you will be able to see that.
So there is no toggle turn on SaaS security posture management. It's basically configure the connectors.
If you already configured Defender for Cloud Apps, it's there. Okay. I will add a quick note. We currently have a number of apps and we are increasing those apps. And we're actually very much listening for customer feedbacks for which apps we are adding. So far, we are trying to focus on the apps that are the most used. That's the one that you saw in this demo. So we're very much listening on where are the next steps. This is one of our top area of investment. So we want to be attentive to what our customers have to say about this.
What are my options then to actually improve it? Like, what can I do? Is there like a automated configuration? Does it show me, hey, you need to go to Salesforce? Can it help? Can, like, because it's not our configuration, it's basically on the other side.
What we have now is we provide a step-by-steps in the console, as we showed, and we are able to provide a quick link so that admins from the other apps will exactly know how to relate. Doing things such as auto-configuration is a bit more invasive. It may happen in the future. We are listening, again, we're listening to customers, and this is something we haven't done yet, but we're open to it in the future.
That's awesome. Okay, good. So we talked about, we clarified what it is. We clarified that it is included in Microsoft Defender for Cloud Apps. So there is nothing someone needs to, first of all, purchase or even configure. It's there up and running. It's super important and critical in general to look at the secure score and make sure that all the components have the best practices applied, not just Defender for Cloud Apps.
Thank you.
And that we are, basically evolving from a CASB solution to a SaaS solution, which is more than a CASB today with additional components. Is there anything that you think we need to let the audience know? Maybe we have a link to share where they can learn more or something?
Well, we have our documentation, and we will have additional blogs that we will publish in the future. So stay tuned. We really want to make sure that our customers take advantage of that feature set, because it's a very powerful one and it's a free one. You already pay for it. So why not leverage it? And it will really, really enhance the security.
Yeah. And basically go to the portal and check it out. Right. So yeah. Depending on who is responsible for what, when it comes to monitoring the security, look at the entire secure score or filter it for cloud apps and then the applications that are important to you. Okay, David, I think that's it. Thank you so much for being my expert on today's show. And thanks everyone for watching. And last reminder, if you are interested in getting one of those plushcats, go to aka.ms/plushcat. And I wish you good luck that you make it to get one. Goodbye.